Cranial nerve 3, or the oculomotor nerve, innervates most of the extraocular muscles, and this includes the levator palpebrae superioris, the superior rectus, the medial rectus, the inferior rectus, and the inferior oblique. It also has a parasympathetic component that comes through and innervates the constrictor pupillae muscle of the iris and the ciliary muscles, which attach to your lens and allow you to accommodate for near vision. In this image, we can see the orbit with the eyeball in place, the eyeball or the orb, as it is referred to. And in this one, we have taken the eyeball out. The muscles that you can see do not include the levator palpebrae superioris. That one's already gone. But here is our superior rectus, our inferior rectus, and our medial rectus. We can also see the inferior oblique. And all of these muscles are innervated by cranial nerve 3. You can see them again here. Here's the inferior oblique, inferior rectus, medial rectus, and the superior rectus up here. The parasympathetic component of the third cranial nerve innervates the constrictor muscles of the pupil. So the constrictor muscles are found out here in the iris, okay? And there are two muscles that make the iris change size, make the pupil change size. So the pupil is this dark spot, and it's dark because there's nothing there. It's an actual hole. And that is where the light is going through to get to your retina. There are muscle fibers that constrict the pupil in bright light, and then there are a separate set of muscle fibers that open the pupil when it's dark. The oculomotor neuron, or the oculomotor nerve, carries the fibers that constrict the pupil. It also carries fibers that innervate something that we can't see in any of these images, but it's tiny little what are called ciliary muscles. And they attach to the lens, which is just behind the pupil, and the lens changes shape when you need to accommodate for near vision. So when you go to the physician and they ask you to put your finger out way in front of you, and they ask you to bring it forward towards your nose and follow it, that ability of your eyes to accommodate for the difference in distance from far to near is called accommodation, and you need your parasympathetics to be able to do that. In the next section, we'll talk about cranial nerves 4 and 6.